Hello friends, welcome to today's video. I think the stock market is quite overvalued now, especially in the United States leading up to the elections in November. So we might get a nice pullback during which some of the growth stocks that have surged in the last 3 to 6 months may take a greater hit than some of the more value-oriented companies, especially the ones that pay a reasonable dividend and have strong operating fundamentals. I'm not saying we should totally shy away from investing in growth companies altogether, but it is always good to balance your investments into different types of stocks, which should help to diversify your risks. So today, I want to talk about how I evaluate dividend stocks to see if they are fairly valued, and what are the key metrics to consider before buying them. I'll also discuss one of the dividend stocks which I plan to buy now, and also show you an alternate way of buying it if you also think that the market in general is overvalued at this time. Let's get going. So when evaluating dividend stocks, I look at certain key metrics that determine the health of the company as well as the safety of the dividends. Without these key metrics lining up, it will be quite risky to just buy some random stock just because the dividend yield is high. The important metrics I look into are whether the company is operating in an industry that has a strong or relatively safe potential for the next decade or two. So for instance, companies in the technology sector or the financial sector would be favored over retail or the oil industry. The next metric I look at is the revenues of the company, which should show a steady increase over the recent 5 or 10 year period. Similar to the revenues of the company, the earnings should also show a steady increase over time. Moving along, the next metric I look at is the debt to equity ratio, which should ideally be less than 1, and the lower this ratio is, the better. Another key metric to look at is the dividend payout ratio. This is calculated by dividing the earnings per share by the dividend per share. The safe payout ratio level varies by industry, but I like to choose companies that have a ratio that is less than 60%. Overall, the lower this ratio, the better, as this gives the company more room to keep increasing the dividend payment in future years. Next, we look at the dividend increase history of the company. Obviously, the longer the better, and I tend to favor companies that have paid increasing dividends consecutively for at least a 10-year period. The next metric we look at is the dividend yield. This is quite relative if the other metrics above are found satisfactory. And depending on your personal situation, you may want to choose companies that pay a higher dividend over others. But at a high level, the decision should be tied to the risk-free interest rate you can get from safer fixed income products like treasury bills and savings accounts. Personally, I would like the dividend yield to be 2.5 or 3% higher than the risk-free options. So in the current market conditions, with the interest rate near zero, I would ideally want to buy dividend stocks which pay around 2.5 or 3% or more, and obviously the higher the yield, the better. And the final metric I like to look at is the dividend growth rate in the recent 5-year period. I like to buy companies that have grown their dividends at least by 7% compounded over the last 5 years. This is usually a good indication that the dividend can be expected to grow at a fair pace, at least over the next decade. Now let's look at a popular dividend stock and see how it fares against the metrics we have outlined so far. The stock I want to share with you today is TROW Price Group Incorporated, ticker symbol TROW. The T. Rowe Price Group is a global investment management organization founded in 1937. As of August 2020, it manages assets worth $1.34 trillion on behalf of both individual and institutional investors. The company also offers a variety of financial services like mutual fund offerings, sub-advisory services, retirement planning, investment planning, and also act as financial intermediaries. Let's now review how the company lines up against the metrics we discussed earlier. In terms of the industry, the company is operating in the financial services sector, which is not the best in terms of long-term growth potential, like say the technology sector, but I would say it is a pretty decent sector to be investing in, especially in companies like this with such long history, as long as the fundamentals of the company is good. As for the revenues of the company, as you can see in this chart, the revenues have been trending up steadily over the last 5 years, and this is aligned with our benchmark expectation for a good dividend stock. Similar to the revenues, the earnings have also been increasing steadily, which again passes our benchmark expectations. Now talking about the debt to equity ratio, TROW is actually debt-free, so this can be considered a big plus as the company would be well prepared to handle any economic downturns that may come up, much better than some of the other companies out there with very heavy debt levels. Let's now look at the dividend payout ratio. T. Rowe's current estimated dividends for 2020 is $3.60 per share, and since the estimated earnings per share is $8.72, this equates to a 41% dividend payout ratio. As you can see, this is much better than our desired benchmark of 60% or lower. In terms of dividend increase history, T. Rowe has a remarkable record of increasing their dividend for 34 consecutive years. This is well past our benchmark of 10 years. As you can also see in this chart, they also have the tendency to pay additional special dividends every now and then, and this is usually a trait seen in very well-managed, shareholder-friendly dividend companies. Coming to the dividend yield, the current yield is 2.53%, which under the current interest rate situation is a pretty decent yield and is more or less equal to our benchmark expectations. Finally, looking at the dividend growth rate, the compound annual dividend growth rate over the last 5 years has been 11.6%, which is again well ahead of our benchmark expectation, and this is even without considering the special dividends paid out in 2015. Now that we have reviewed how T. Rowe fares against all the metrics we laid out, it can be clearly seen that this company would qualify as a good dividend stock to invest in. However, before committing our hard-earned money, let us also look at a final critical aspect I usually evaluate before buying any stock in general. This is to assess where we are in the overall economic cycle and to review how changes in the economic cycle would affect the company we are looking to invest in. So from this perspective, it could be argued that the economy is a bit overvalued, and T. Rowe especially would stand to lose revenues from an economic downturn, as their business model mainly revolves around collecting fees for managing assets for their institutional and individual investor clients. In a downturn, typically these investors tend to sell their holdings and sit on cash. So we may want to wait for lower prices to invest in T. Rowe, especially after the recent run-up in the stock price, even though it meets all of our benchmarks for a good dividend stock. But again, there are always multiple ways we can play the investing game instead of just waiting for the stock to drop. So our options include buying a part at current prices and wait for lower prices to buy more. Typically, if I choose this method, I would like to decide how much money I want to invest in this company overall and then use up to 20 or 30% of that cash to buy some shares at the current price and buy more at every 5 or 10% price drops. The second way to invest is to sell put options at a lower price while we wait for the stock to drop in price. For waiting, we would be rewarded with the premium that we collect now from selling the put options. I personally like this method better as it gives me the flexibility of collecting some profits and at the same time have the ability to pick a lower price at which I would like to buy the stock in case I feel it is a bit overvalued currently. So for example, we could sell the $120 put option expiring in December 2020 for $2.15. This would give us a 9.48% annualized return and at the same time give us the opportunity to buy the stock 15% lower than the current stock price in case there is a sell-off in the market. I have explained this concept of selling put options in my previous videos as well and the things that you have to keep in mind when using this strategy. But please let me know in the comment section if you have any questions about the strategy, and I would be happy to answer them. So based on the above analysis, I will personally be selling some December 2020 put options on T. Rowe price, and I hope you also found this video interesting and provided a good framework on how to identify and invest in quality dividend stocks. And as a friendly disclaimer, please note that I am not a licensed investment advisor, and my videos are only meant to document my views on various investment-related topics that I'm interested in. So please consult with your own investment advisor before making any investment decisions. And if you enjoyed this video and found the information useful, I would really appreciate if you can please leave a like below and subscribe to my channel. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.